Reactor online. Sensors online. Weapons online. All systems nominal.
Hey everyone, BOMB Flyer here. I wanted to do this video about keeping a journal and why I've found that it's really helpful for me and what I think the benefits are for someone that's either starting out painting or has been painting for a while. I didn't always keep a journal. I've been painting for the better part of 2 decades. Unfortunately, a lot of the things that I learned how to do and figured out are long gone. And the nice thing about writing it down is that you always know where it is. Before I got to a journal, I would write stuff down on note cards. Didn't always have exactly what I wanted on there. Sometimes the handwriting was hard to read, but I moved on from these partly because I ran out of room. Another reason was because the little card file thing that I put them in, I just found hard to navigate, and I found I had to write too small. But what I did like about using note cards, and you may want to take away from this, is you can use it for color sampling. Now, it's not exactly the way it'll appear on a miniature, but the nice part is if you follow your recipe and then you do a little dab on the same type of paper and it looks the same, then that's exactly what you were trying to achieve. Another thing I did was stick some pieces of metal and try to do a kind of a recipe on this, but if I had to do over again, I would take some styrene and prime it and do what I would actually be painting as far as a miniature is concerned, but you get the idea. So that's something that maybe you can add to your bag of tricks, but I don't keep my recipes on note cards anymore. I graduated from that to this kind of a green note taker book. Unfortunately, it wasn't a dedicated painting journal, so I have all kinds of crap in here. What I ended up doing though, from time to time when I'd think of something, was jot something down, doodle something. If an idea struck me at a time or whatever, this is where it would go. Again, it was better than not writing it down at all, but this book has all kinds of other things in it and it's not really a dedicated painting journal. Which leads me to this, which I got about 7 years ago, I believe, customized it a little bit because I felt like it, and started writing in a consistent format. I would put the date, the unit, the models I was painting, and then just go through what steps I followed in order, and I was just consistent with that over and over again. And I've added to it throughout everything that I've painted since then, and even went back and found old recipe cards and things like that that I had originally made, and went back and added them in, even if it was a scheme that I'd already painted. So I have a couple different entries for the same type of thing, which is fine, especially if you decide you want to try a new technique and you end up finding 2 or 3 ways that you like to paint something. Also threw in, you can see kind of what a card looks like here. I still use these, but reason I use them is because I airbrush in my garage, which is separate from where I normally paint, and I don't like taking the book in there and doing all that. Plus, it's easier just to make a few notes, or if I'm, you know, maybe not home and I'm painting. Sometimes I do that when I paint on the road. I'll jot what I did down. That way I don't have to bring the book with me and then I come back and update it. I also throw in little sketches and doodles and things like that that I want to do maybe for a diorama. Things like that. It's basically a notebook that you would have with a bunch of stuff every now and then that gets stuffed in there. But I really like the idea of being able to go back to something, see what I did, find the procedure, and then go, oh, I want to change that, or I want to follow that exactly, or refer to it to another section, so on and so forth. And I do this for every miniature. It's not just BattleTech, but I've really found it useful. And then additionally, when someone asks me how I do something, if I don't recollect the exact way, I can go and look it up, or I can share my procedure. And if they come across something that I think is better, I might go back and adapt the colors that I use and follow a different process, or try something that they recommended and then maybe change it and make a note or even write a whole new entry. So I really recommend this. It saves you a lot of trouble. The example I want to give is I painted this miniature a decade and a half ago. It's for a book. I wish I would have been better, but I'm a lot better painter now. The problem is at the time I was trying to paint two. Did not ever get the second one done. I would really love to have had that the explanation of what I did on there, even though it's probably just a light blue and a white. I don't remember specifically which colors, which brands, if I did any mixing, what order I put them on. So basically I have to figure it out. Now, I'm a much different painter technically now than I was before, but why add more effort to the challenge, especially if you go back and want to add a couple of lances to a unit that you painted to make a company, and you want to make them look all the same. Now, it's fine if you want to paint them better than the way you did before, but maybe you don't. And this is a great example of how you could go back to that, follow the same procedure, you'd have the names of the paints and all that, and it would really help you out. So I want to just quickly explain that. tell you guys what I thought. I appreciate you guys watching and hanging out. I know it's not a painting video. Follow us on Facebook. Give us a like over on YouTube. Subscribe. Let us know what you think in the comments. Give us some questions, any suggestions below, and we'll see you next time.
Shutdown sequence initiated.